1925, when a Siberian immigrant named Anatol Josepho unveiled the world's first fully automatic photographic machine in Times Square in New York City. He crowned his invention the Photomaton, costing him $11,000 to make. People wound all the way around the block, waiting for hours at a chance to have their pictures captured. It was such a success that Josepho received $1 million, which is around $14 million in today's money, plus future royalties for his invention. Photomatons soon began to pop up all across the country. A photomaton concession stand placed on Broadway in 1932 was so successful it kept the owner's extended family employed throughout the Great Depression. At the cost of a quarter, you receive a strip of 8 images of you, a loved one, you and a loved one, in a process that took roughly 8 minutes. Over the next few decades, artists, actors, presidents, and citizens alike flocked to photo booths to have their pictures taken. So why not monsters too? Supplies you're going to need today: a piece of paper in the vertical fashion, a pencil with an eraser, a juicy Sharpie or black marker, and some colored pencils. We're going to start with your paper in the vertical fashion, not horizontal, vertical. For my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise, holding your paper in the vertical fashion, you are going to then fold your paper in half the long way. So match up the long sides so it's like a hot dog bun. Not a hamburger bun, but a hot dog bun. Keeping your paper folded, we're now going to divide your paper into 3 equal sections. You should be using pencil for this. I'm going to use Sharpie so you can see it better. And now we're going to draw 2 horizontal lines. So we're going to go about a third of the way down the paper, draw a horizontal line, and then another third of the way, and another horizontal line. So we have 3 equal sections. We're going to work with the space of our monsters. How are they spaced out? So the top one, they're going to be spaced further apart. They might even go off the page a little bit. You're going to draw 2 shapes. I'm going to do these curved shapes, but you could do squares or rectangles. It's up to you. Make sure that there's space in between those first 2 shapes. Now in the middle section, we're going to repeat those same shapes, but we're going to make them closer together. They could either be touching or even just slightly overlapping. Now in the bottom section, we're going to repeat those shapes once again, but we're going to make them overlap. And that's going to show that our monsters are now super close together, like right on top of each other. Here's where we get to have a lot of fun using your imagination for your monsters. So you could start with the eyes. You could have 1 eye, 2, more. It's up to you. Don't forget eyebrows. Make sure you add details like hair, the nose, a funny mouth. What do you have for teeth? A tongue. And then add some arms. Then repeat this process for your second monster, and I would give them a totally different personality. So you could do different amount of eyes or different arms, hair, you name it, have some fun. Now the second frame, you're going to do the same features of the monsters in the first one because they are the same monsters, but you could change up their expressions slightly if you'd like, or the way that they're moving. I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld an eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise, and suddenly, to my surprise, he did the monster mash. The monster mash. It was a graveyard smash. He did the mash. It caught on in a flash. He did the mash.
the Monster Mash, from my laboratory in the castle east, to the master bedroom where the vampires feast. The ghouls all came from their humble abode to get a jolt from my electrode.
They did the mash.
They did the Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
They did the mash.
They did the Monster Mash. The zombies were having fun.
Then once again, in the bottom frame, the same exact features of your original monsters, but you could change up their expressions a little bit and have some fun again.
Dracula and his son. The scene was rocking, all were digging the sounds. Igor on chains, backed by his baying hounds. The coffin bangers were about to arrive with their vocal group, the Crypt Kicker Five.
They played the mash.
They played the Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
They played the mash.
It got on in a flash.
They played the mash.
They played the Monster Mash. Out from his coffin, Rex's voice did ring. Seemed he was troubled by just one thing. Opened the lid and shook his fist and said, whatever happened to my Transylvania twist?
It's now the mash.
It's now the Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
And it's a graveyard smash.
It's now the mash.
It's caught on in a flash.
It's now the mash.
And then the last step is we're going to have some fun coloring in our monsters. Now, if I were you, I would color in the first monster in all three sections, making sure that it's the same color, and then go back and do the same thing for the second monster in all three sections.
Then you can Monster Mash.
The Monster Mash.
And do my graveyard smash.
Then you can mash.
You'll catch on in a flash.
Then you can mash.
Then you can Monster Mash.
And then, of course, we have to fill in the background. Don't forget the background. We don't want any white space on our artwork, except for where it makes sense, for like an eyeball or teeth or something like that. So if I were to put on my future glasses, your artwork might look something like this. I can't wait to see what you come up with.